Yeah, great fun. Back down in the basement once again. It's Dan here, and this is the Maruszczyk Elwood 4P bass, and I am absolutely loving it. So look at this. Is this the first completely white bass that we've had down in the basement? I think it looks absolutely stunning. Let's get up to the headstock and we'll do the usual zoom through, have a listen to what the bass is capable of, and talk a bit more about it. So here we go, up we go. Maruszczyk, little emblem there, and the bass name, Elwood. If you know your Blues Brothers, you'll know what this means straight away. So for the jazz bass models, these are known as the Elwood models. And should you have the one of the precision style basses, we've got the Jake models. We have gold hardware, shiny gold hardware. It's that shiny, you can see my fingerprints on it where I've been tuning the bass up. Okay, I'm gonna flip the bass over. Let's have a look. Angled back headstock, big tick in the box for me, as you know, have you seen my reviews previously? Okay, we've got hip shot tuning keys, so super lightweight. And look at this, the white bodywork, absolutely everywhere. So the back of the neck as well, this is a maple neck. And right down the back of the body as well, an ash body. Covered in this lovely, gorgeous, glossy white finish. Gold hardware right down to the fixings for the neck. And of course, the strap button as well. Okay, talk about the active pickups in just a moment. So there's a battery compartment. And gold screws on the compartment here for your electronics. A small touch, but a very, very nice one. Flipping the bass over then, we'll go back to the fretboard. Okay, first thing I am a massive fan of already is I love a zero fret. I've always liked them on basses, and I like the feel of them as well. It's for me, it's just a small thing, but I like this idea that when you fret a note at the first fret, you know that if there's a bass with a zero fret on it, then it's going to be at the right height. It's not going to be so much higher than the other frets because of a badly cut nut or anything like that. Not that I expect anything like that from one of these instruments anyway. They really are so well made. So, made in Poland. Very, very nice indeed. Coming down the fretboard. Interestingly, when I plugged this bass in for the first time, even without turning on an amp, I thought, wow, it's a particularly bright sounding bass guitar. And I had a feeling that it might be an all maple neck. And as I understand it, now I've got the specifications, it's a maple neck and a maple fretboard as well. So reminiscent of my all maple bass I have at home, very bright sounding. Fretwork, exemplary. Not a single edge on it at all. Right, absolutely brilliant. I'm gonna roll this over a little bit so you can see this edge work. And there's a really nice edge to it. I reviewed another Maruszczyk bass in the past. And what was interesting about that is I found the edge of the neck of that super nice as well. So straight out of the box. There we go. Black markers against the white gloss. You're not gonna miss those, are you? Okay, down on the fretboard as well, we've got these lovely black markers. Like that. And I think this looks really nice. I really like the idea of a painted fretboard now. I've never had a bass with a painted fretboard. Gorgeous, really nice indeed. Coming down onto the body, of course, as I mentioned, it is a J-style bass, it is a jazz bass. So, iconic design, sits on your lap, feels really, really nice. There's a cutaway here for the body. And truss rod, Let's cut away here so you can actually get in and adjust it without actually having to remove the neck or anything like that. Again, the neck is set up beautifully. No need to touch that out of the box, it's great. Electronics, we've got passive controls over here. We've got a master volume, a pan control with a center click for the bridge, the bridge and neck pickups, and then a master tone. Now, with these pickups, as I said, there's a battery involved. These pickups are active. That means each of these units has a little electronic circuit in, just to oversimplify, to help with creating a good, powerful, strong tone. So they need the battery to power it. No other like onboard electronics in this case. However, I know that as custom options, you can pretty much order whatever you like with these bases. So you could go for an active circuit should you need it. This base, I don't think it does. Active pickups, passive tone control. We'll have a listen to that in a moment. I think I'm riding about 50%. So I've just backed off the very top of brightness because they've got a nice sheen to the sound. Then over to this beast, a nice big hefty bridge on this as well, which interestingly, considering it's so large, I don't think it looks out of place. I think it looks kind of cool. For those who have probably been kind of like muttering this under their breath from the start of the video, Larry Graham does indeed come to mind. And I really like it. I've always loved his white jazz basses, and this one is just seems reminiscent of that. So I was very, very careful not to kind of overdo it on the slap bass because I probably wouldn't do it justice anyway. Okay, then let's get on and have a listen to the individual pickup settings on this. Volume all the way open. So just a little bit of pick work for both pickups again. Now the action on this bass is mega, mega low. So we're getting a few little buzzes and things like that, but not a problem. You could just lift it a little bit and that'd be absolutely fine. So don't worry if you're getting a few buzzes here. I like to dig in with a plectrum anyway, so a little bit of metal against metal has never really upset me too much. Front pickup then, here we go. This is the EMG X models, and this is the front pickup. And then going around to the bridge pickup, let's have a little listen to that. Being the active EMG pickups, they are very, very sensitive. And I'm noticing that I'm picking up every single one of my idiosyncrasies in my playing, should we say? But there's a really nice sound there with the bridge pickup. That's why I put the plectrum down, because I thought, oh wow, this is a really good opportunity to hear that sound. It doesn't sound brittle. It's got a nice bit of bite to it, but it also gives nicely as well. So if I was playing a softer sound, the brightness wasn't overpowering. So that's a really, really nice touch. I've gone back to the 50-50 mix in between, and I'm gonna try, see if we can do a bit of a 60-40. So I'm gonna back it off a little bit towards the bridge. Let's see where that sweet spot is. Sensitive on the dial, I think it's about there. Yeah, I think it's there. It's nice. As I dug in a bit, as I said, kind of got a bit of that low action choking going off, but it's a nice bit of snarl to the sound, I think. Very, very nice. Yeah, I'm liking that a lot. Okay, so the 60-40 thing definitely does carry over. That's really cool. Tone control, as I said, I'm kind of on 50-50, so I'm going to wind it all the way open, and we're going to hear all of the top end. Going back the other way, let's go all the way down. So I'm going to go for some nice dubby tones. Great, I carried on playing there for a moment and you probably saw me nudging the dial back. I was trying to find a point where the top end just rolled off a bit more than that 50-50 kind of mix thing. And that's super cool. I'm getting a nice bit of bass throb there, but the bass still has its character to it, its jazz top end. Rounding off with a last little bit of slap bass there, just so we can hear that softer top end attack. Sounds absolutely excellent. So then, rounding up. This is a very, very cool bass indeed. I've been mega happy with this one. Could quite easily just grab this one and take it straight to a gig. It feels that comfortable. The action, as I said, is a bit on the low side. I'd probably just tweak it just a wee bit. That might be just where it's just come over from Poland and it's just settling itself. Looks great, sounds great, feels super comfortable as well. And actually at the price point, it's really reasonable for essentially what is an entirely custom bass. So rounding up, here we go. This is the Maruszczyk Elwood 4 bass. As usual, more information in the written review. But for now, I hope you've enjoyed checking out the video. I'll see you again soon.